We're going to be working on things that are called dance. Okay. Now, these are arms. This is a head. This is the nose and the head. These are the shoulders. These are the elbows. These are all the things that a dancer uses to make up his dance. All the hands up, 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 up. Now, in the hands, let's think of all the parts in just the hands. There's the fingertips. Let's see those fingertips. There's the knuckles, little fists. There's the wrists. And the wrist can bend forward and back in circles with the knuckles and the fingertips. And in front, we have a couple of big elbows, which can go up and down. They can touch. One can go up, one can go down. All those things with those elbows. Then the whole hand can reach ahead of you, can slap on them, can touch the chest, can touch the head, can touch, cover the eyes, can do all these things with just the hands. Let's do a tap dance for just the hands. So you see, you don't have to tap dance with just the feet. You tap dance with the hands when you have nothing to do, when your feet are cold. Okay, down come the hands. This is the head. What's in front of the head? What's the thing sticking out of that head?
A nose.
Okay, with the nose. Let me see a dance with just that nose.
Look, if we've got little children right here in the audience, you can come right down and touch them and see if someone would come with you. See if someone would come right on stage. It would be so beautiful if one of the children would come right on stage. Okay. Now, check hair. Someone has to check your bang. What, dear?
Who knows what your dance instrument is? Who knows what is it? Your own body. And everybody has one. And you want to take good care of it and work it beautifully and fully all the time. And that's the very first thing that we're going to show you is how we train the dancer's body. But I think you'll find it very interesting. So if the girls will pull the curtain, we'll start with training the dancer's body.
Curve, it's very long. Take it like a great wheel across the head. Let the other arm go down to that hip. Push it out of the way. Now stretch through that arm. Good. Down arm, reach. Clasp and stretch. Keep the shoulders open, the weight on both heels. Lift up. Go over the top. Oh. Oh. Breath out easily. Last time, other side. And hip. Stretch out. Stretch out. Good. Take the other arm on a wheel. Over. Palm to palm. Weight on both heels. Good. Lift. And slow. Open. Relax the arms. And turn parallel. It's very nicely done. Good corrections as you began to find the weight go into the floor. Hang forward once again, please, all the way down. Pulling the elbows out near your ears till you feel as though you're rounded over a great hoop. Elbows pulling out as well. In the count of four, hip under one, middle in two, elbows curving three, head shaping in four, and let go. Head turning very easily. Stay there. Stay there, your head forward. Now, feel this go right. Don't move your head. Don't move your shoulders. Just this.
My emphasis for this workshop will be movement as a concept, not movement as a skill. In other words, take it as you would take any idea to place it in your classroom for your children. For instance, three questions. What is it? What does it stand for? What does it feel like in your body? The what is it? The what does it stand for can be answered 100 ways. The additional in-depth statement, what does it feel like in your body, is the only area, this is the only area in which that enrichment can come. For instance, what is it? Two circles, please. We find two circles, I don't care how you do it. We do it this way if you want. Two circles. Put one at the side of the other, or one on top of the other. Doesn't make any difference. What is it?
An eight.
All right, it is something, it's two circles, it stands for something, it's an eight. Will you now feel what it feels like in the body? And now I'm going to ask you to move it as large as you can. With two arms, please, go. Feel and figure eight. Two arms, as large as you can. Place the figure eight to the sides of your body. Good. Over your head. Clasp your arms behind your back. Do a figure eight with the torso only. Feel what it feels like. Figure eight. Do you follow where it is? Good. Very good. Walk it on the floor. A big one, a generous figure eight. Begin to pick up, when you have finished the figure eight on the floor, pick up a figure eight in the arm on top of it. So you're now doing a figure eight on the floor, a figure eight in the arms. Add, figure eight on the floor, figure eight in the arms. Keep the figure eight on the floor going, and the figure eight in the arms going. Add to it a figure eight in the body. Good, good. Bring it to stillness and now take a figure eight the way a child would normally do a figure eight. Pick up an imaginary pencil. Can you sense the difference between what you did and what is required? Now they are related for me in that if you can feel it in those large muscle sets in space, there is an enrichment of the fact that you're trying to find out how to do it here. Dance, if taken into the body, has a different significance than if you take it into the mind only.
One, two, ready, and go. Try to keep the weight on the front of the foot. One, two, three, and go. What we do now is go into a creative part of the class.
Feel what you have in your body, and you're going to take that shape and move it to another place in the room. Don't lose it.
Go slowly. Move that shape.
If you're down, that's you're stuck with that. Move it. Move it. Move it. But exactly that shape. Take it somewhere else in the room.
Don't change it. Move it with speed. Move it with speed. Good. And
good. Good. Keep it moving.
That same shape.
That same shape. Very nice. Very nice.
Her sense is very accurate. She's a little freer in how she wants to take that. And that flat line keeps moving to me.
She had a feeling inside her of what that shape was.
There you go. Go from shape to shape slowly. Good.
You're going to have to pick and choose. For instance, happening here, an inside and outside shape. Two outside shapes with an additional piece. Notice how he now is going to manipulate the piece. That's very nice. I'm sorry we have to hurry you in this fashion. Two outside fabrics pulling against an inside fabric.
Wow, that's amazing.
That's really beautiful. Very nice indeed. Very nice. Will you undo your fabrics, just bring them to the center, and class is through, children. Thank you very much.
And I hope if you want to see more, you'll come to the Woodrow Wilson Jr. You count them.
No, you
My children will hide this morning because
that's
rainy
natural.
Weather, so
I know. What are your
I'm
needs
a worry
in
wart. My individual or my class?
No, your individual. I'm here for you more than your class.
I feel that, put on your good listening ears and very quietly move out onto the floor and find your own space without touching your friends.
The things that I found I would have avoided, direct imitation of something they really cannot be. For instance, you got them to pumpkins, and a pumpkin is a non-moving thing. Mm-hmm. They did very logical things. They exploded, which you didn't want. But there's very little else you can do with that. So instead of that, it might be, what is the shape of a pumpkin? Where might it move if it could move? How would it move? In other words, you now want to move them not to be pumpkins, which are rooted. Predictably, the lifespan of motion with that image was short. You couldn't have extended it, neither could they. So you want to take that image and find its motional possibility.
No!
He was
mad.
I want to see your faces.
Oh, I don't believe you. I believe Daphne. Leonard, I don't believe you. I believe Wes. Willie, I believe. I believe you.
Oh, those are better.
Now make it happen in your arms and hands. He was so mad.
Who could make it happen in their whole self?
Well, if you're a boy, go show me. Now those boys are going to be so mad. Oh, Barry, that's a good mad one.
Look at those good mad designs of those children. Do it once again. Now, you're not mad at each other, so you can't touch each other, but you're a group of angry children. He was so mad!
When I was in your city the other day,
what happened, Cynthia?
We done all kinds of dances with her.
Yes, but what happened in the middle of the night?
A storm. A big storm.
A big storm. And then what happened? At the end of the big storm.
A little rain.
Came down. So gentle and so soft at the end of the big storm. And then the wind whipped up again, and it was angry mad.
And the wind blowed away the little rain.
There they go! As mad, angry as they can be! With your back! Go up in the air! Down on the floor! And go back to the piano.
Baby drum. Very nice. Good. These people won't clap, but they will make various sounds with what they're holding. One of them is to actually beat them on the floor and against each other. When you take the section of six, Iris, where you come from the side,
so they make their own music, as it were, with the sticks on the floor against each other, and sometimes you heard the foot. That kind of sound. Sean, do the first thing that you do with that. The sound that the beater makes when it swishes across the surface of the air. And he has to learn to do that rhythmically. Notice that they cue each other.
Warning to 11. Warning to 11.